Fasting can be the fountain of youth, don't you think? Better skin, better nails, stronger, and better sleep. Fasting is anti-aging. Now, it's great for your physical health. We all know this. We know the benefits that come with it. I'm not here to give you a science-based background to why fasting works for us, but I think you guys know this. You've probably done your research with many, many other channels and read and looked online about fasting. Sometimes there's not enough science-based studies that may be good enough for others, but this is what works for me. What I do know about fasting is that it is backed by many, many Bible verses. So in the book of Matthew, Jesus was doing his most famous Sermon on the Mountain to his disciples and other followers. Don't quote me on this, it's just that I'm not as good as citing the Bible. But what I received is that he, Jesus Christ that is, presumed that you will fast. He said when you fast, not if. That in itself stopped me in my tracks when I heard this and I read it. And basically, he does expect us to fast. Now, it's not in the Ten Commandments or anything like that, but fasting is a form of humility before the Lord. Fasting is disconnecting us from the world, and prayer is connecting us to God. That's the bottom line. And that's all I needed to continue my journey in living the fasting lifestyle. I found so many, many verses that would overwhelm anyone. But there is a difference from spiritual fasting versus physical fasting. Spiritual fasting is about connecting to God, as mentioned. It's about being humbled before the Lord. Doing these things, you're not worried about your vanity. I, again, started fasting because of vanity reasons. And then it became more of just having good, optimal physical health. And I found so many benefits there. You know, the clarity, the skin, the nails, clarity in your mind, energy, attacking inflammation in your body. This is wonderful, absolutely. But then, as I did more extended fasts, I came across God. Go figure, yeah? I came across God. I started to seek Him. And He said, seek Him first. He is the priority in our lives. And if we do those things, He will grant us peace, and He will grant us more love than any of us can imagine. This is huge in my book. So in other physical fasts, it can be distracting because it is thinking about and planning for what you would eat when you break the fast. So that can be a distraction in itself. But with spiritual fasting, you're not worried about these things once you go back into your normal eating plan. Spiritual fasting is about taking ownership in what we have done in our immediate past, what we need to connect with God to communicate and get answers from Him. So you're denying the flesh. And when you do these things, it honors Him so much. And yes, I want to be in favor in His eyes. It's an incredible thing that you guys are doing, that you can even fast. The majority of the world cannot even fast a day without breaking their fast and just giving up. Maybe they're going in it for the wrong reasons, just like there have been times that I've gone into it for the wrong reasons. I think you have to ask yourself why you're doing it, have that goal set, and we can make all the plans we want. God will just laugh at us and mess up your plans anyway, because it's His plan that's for us and His will that will carry us through, giving us the purpose in life of what we're here on earth to do. And that really is to help others ultimately. And we have to use ourselves as the example of what we've gone through, the trials and tribulations, the sins that we have committed, which is obviously ongoing. It's always a battle. I know for me that just to work on a simple thing like watching my tongue, watching what I say, because that can be more of a deadly weapon than anything else. I found a new app that really helps me with being still and reading more of the Bible. And it came through the Bible app, which is the YouVersion. And that's my go-to when I need to read in the morning or in the evenings before I go to bed. You know, guys, I told you I'm very much a procrastinator when it comes down to reading more from the Bible, whatever message He wants to say to me to get my day started the right way. Then that usually leads me to reading the whole chapter of that verse. I want to read on my own and just read through the whole book. And so that's a wonderful app. So if you guys can check that out, and I'll show you some more apps that I'm using as well. The YouVersion prompted me to go into a meditation and prayer, help you with sleep, anxiety, because anxiety is a big thing for me, chronically speaking. And I heard from the audience that also battles with anxiety as well. There are so many verses that I read for anxiety buster type prayers, and I find that very useful, especially when you say it out loud and you mean it, and you say this to God. And that's made such a difference in my life when I feel attacked or I feel overwhelmed in general. So the YouVersion Bible app prompted me to go into the Abide app. What a wonderful surprise that I received in the past week or so. It's helping me with my sleep, and it gives you Bible verses while you're sleeping. So if you're looking for something that would help you on the spiritual fast, or help you with sleep, help you with the anxiety, the depression, Abide, check it out. What was I trying to say? I think you should think about when you're going to do a spiritual fast. It doesn't take much planning when you're already a pro, or you began the journey of fasting anyway for weight loss or just for health reasons. Fasting spiritually will give you more answers than you can ever imagine, especially when it comes down to your own life and how you can be better. I encourage you, and you guys encourage me as well, to continue seeking God and to give more of a spiritual connection versus just the physical and the mental. Because at the end of the day, you're being granted peace, then that correlates to your mental health and well-being, right? It also moves right into your physical, because your body is a temple and you're treating it well. And that is what this is all about. I have more videos that are on spiritual health and touch on it a little bit, so please do check out. I have a playlist that I put together. I'm trying to organize the page better for you guys so you can find videos that pertain to what you want to see and what you want to hear. If you have any questions, please do leave a comment. My question for you is, how are you doing your spiritual fast? And are you interested in it at all? Because you know what? You just might find something out new about yourself, as well as something new in the relationship that you are having with God. And if you don't have one, this is a way to get started. Puts a smile on your face and puts a smile on the Most High. Don't forget, caregiving begins with you. And thanks so much for watching, guys. Talk to you soon.